Hello, hello, welcome back and welcome if you're new here. My name's Georgie and I make videos about chronic illness related issues and I'm also a student here at Cambridge Uni studying biological anthropology. Going to be the first in a series of videos I'm making about mast cell activation. I'm really, really excited to make videos on this topic. There isn't much information about it on the internet, so I hope that you find it really useful. And thank you so much to anybody who suggested questions or topics on this area. I'm really excited to cover them for you. So today's topic is going to be about the link between long haul COVID or long COVID and mast cell activation syndrome, or hyperinflammatory syndrome. So to start with a bit of jargon busting, long COVID, sometimes called post-COVID syndrome, refers to symptoms that continue for weeks or months after a COVID-19 infection. And many patients have described long-term impacts such as fatigue, headaches, and also those affecting the heart, the brain, or the gut. Although there isn't much research into this topic yet, there is a connection that's been found with another health condition, which is called mast cell activation syndrome. And this is a condition I happen to have been suffering with for about 10 years now, and it was triggered by a viral infection. So although I'm not a medical professional, I am drawing upon personal experience, and I'm going to summarise everything you need to know about the link, the latest research, and what you can do if you think you might have an ongoing mast cell related illness. So mast cell activation syndrome is a multi-system disorder and it produces a range of allergy-like symptoms. So it's caused by when the mast cells, which are a key part of your immune system, wrongly or excessively release chemical mediators that are inflammatory, such as histamine, and they produce reactions which manifest as physical symptoms. So that could be anything from a runny nose to severe fatigue, headaches, or even problems regulating your heart and blood pressure and brain fog. So that's not an exhausted list. If you'd like to learn more about mast cell symptoms or what mast cell activation is, I do have a video that explains everything you could possibly need to know, which I highly recommend watching, so I'll link that above for you. But why is this relevant to COVID-19 long haulers? Well, some of the symptoms that have been experienced by long COVID patients may be related to the same mechanism, where the mast cells dysfunction, and recent research has started to convincingly demonstrate this link. So let's talk through what they found. And just a note, throughout the video, every source of information I'm citing is going to be linked in the description box below. So if you'd like to do any further reading, it'll be just there for you. So could long COVID patients have developed mast cell activation syndrome as a result of an acute viral infection? It would seem so. And recent research has suggested that most patients who developed this type of hyperinflammatory response were ones who didn't develop a severe COVID infection, or who were at risk of mortality. Rather, an acute infection led to later mast cell complications. So this means that you don't have to have had severe COVID to be at risk. If you're someone that suffered a COVID-19 infection or any other viral infection for that matter and developed chronic symptoms, what do you need to look out for and what can you do about it? Let's start with symptoms and getting diagnosed. The symptoms of mast cell activation can be very broad and affect multiple bodily systems. So the best resource to see if your symptoms match up is to look at the Mast Cell Action website, which I will link in the description box below. And this explains what kind of things to look out for, what bodily systems can be affected. But keep in mind that mast cell activation is likely not the only complication of long COVID. So for example, POTS, which is a condition which affects the heart and the nervous system, has also been found to be tentatively linked to long COVID. And I'm very happy to make a video on this if anybody would find it useful also. Just let me know in the comments down below. So in terms of getting diagnosed, this can be quite tricky because at current, there is no single reliable diagnostic test to tell you if you're struggling with mast cell activation. So this means, for example, a blood test wouldn't reveal directly if a patient's suffering from the condition. There is, however, a tryptase test, or your bloods may show inflammatory markers, which could be some sort of indication, but a clinical diagnosis can still be made. So those could be negative, but you could still be struggling with mast cell activation syndrome. So the best suited teams for diagnosing would be the immunology department, and they will often take an assessment of the symptoms, the severity, length of illness, and then discuss possible treatment options. And a lot of the research conducted recently into long COVID and the mast cell connection has been around trying treatments that work for patients suffering with mast cell activation syndrome. And those include medications such as mast cell inhibitors, and they've been trying to see if they also work on the symptoms of long haul COVID. And interestingly, in many long COVID cases, the medications were very successful in providing remission for some of the symptoms suffered. For mast cell patients like myself, the long COVID link has provided an exciting new wave of research, and as we begin to better understand this condition, hopefully further treatment options will be available to manage it. And throughout this mast cell series, I'm going to be highlighting any relevant and recent research as it happens, so stay tuned. But that's all for today. I hope that you found this video about the long COVID mast cell connection useful. Thank you so much for watching. Do join me next week for the next video in the Mast Cell series. Let me know if you have any questions, or feel free to share your own story in the comments. Give this video a like if you found it helpful, and subscribe for more mast cell related content. Take care and see you in my next one.